Grenada. Guatemala. Guyana. Haiti. Honduras. Hong Kong. Indonesia. Iraq. Ireland. Israel. Italy. Ivory Coast. Japan. Kenya. Korea. Japan. Lebanon. Soto. Liberia. Liechtenstein. Luxembourg. Madagascar. Malawi. Malaysia. Mali. Malta. Mauritania. Mauritius. Thank you. Mexico. Monaco. Morocco. Mozambique. Nepal. Netherlands. Netherlands Antilles. New Zealand. Nicaragua. Thank you. Nigeria. Nigeria. Norway. Oman. Pakistan. Panama. Papua New Guinea. Paraguay. Peru. Philippines. Portugal. Puerto Rico. Romania. Rwanda. San Marino. Arabia. Senegal. Seychelles. Sierra Leone. Singapore. Solomon Islands. Somalia. Spain. Sri Lanka. Suriname. Swaziland. Sweden. Switzerland. Syria. Chinese Taipei. Tanzania. Togo. Tonga. Thank you. Turkey. United Arab Emirates. Uruguay. Venezuela. Virgin Islands. Western Samoa. Yemen Arab Republic. Yugoslavia. We'll be right back. a year. Zambia. Zimbabwe. United States of America. We'll be right back. Ladies and gentlemen, assembled before you are the finest athletes in the world, the competitors in the games of the 23rd Olympiad. Ladies and gentlemen, the president of the Los Angeles Olympic Organizing Committee, Mr. Peter V. Uberoff.
Mr. President, honored guests, ladies and gentlemen, it's been said, before you stand the finest group of young men and women ever to assemble in the history of sport. They represent the best that this world has to offer. They represent the best hope for the future of mankind. ...140 very different nations gather here today to honor their own countries and at the same time to honor the Olympic movement. In a few minutes, the Olympic torch will enter this stadium and the games of the 23rd Olympiad will begin. We at the Los Angeles Committee had a new idea, an idea to carry the flame on the longest route in the history of Olympics. It began in the great and wonderful city of New York and went across this country to this historic site of the 1932 Olympic Games. Rather than go on a straight line, we thought it best to wander up and down and crisscross across our country through most major cities and most small communities. The success of this torch run has exceeded our fondest dreams. Millions and millions and millions of our fellow Americans stood by along the roadsides, cheering the runners, and thereby becoming part of the Olympic movement. These Americans had two messages to give to the world. The first is an enormous rekindling of pride in our own country, the United States of America. And more importantly, these millions and millions of people turned out along the way to express a friendship and a love and a caring for all nations of the world. It was an outpouring of pride and love that was demonstrated by a people toward an idea that through sport, we can take an important step toward world peace and understanding. As these games are about to begin, we must thank the thousands upon thousands of people in Southern California who have dedicated years of their lives to this games, and especially during the next 2 weeks, they will dedicate their lives to make these a great games for the athletes of the world. For you see, that's clearly our goal. We wish no political statement. We wish only to show hospitality and friendship, and through these efforts, make a better world if we can. It's now my honor to introduce His Excellency Mr. Juan Antonio Zamorano, President of the International Olympic Committee, to whom I extend the warmest welcome.
Here we are, once again in Los Angeles, where 52 years ago, we celebrated the games of the 10th Olympiad. Today, however, our family is much larger. A record score of 140 national Olympic committees are taking part in these games. We are proud to say that a great many of the finest youth in the world are present with us in this historic Coliseum. May I extend a warm welcome to all the athletes and officials. I am sure that they will compete and participate in the true Olympic spirit of cooperation, understanding, and friendship without any political influence. Nevertheless, our thoughts also go to those athletes who have not been able to join us. On behalf of the Olympic movement, I should like to thank the city of Los Angeles, el pueblo de Nuestra Señora La Reina de Los Ángeles, as it was originally called, the State of California, and the entire nation for receiving us with open arms. Our gratitude must also go to the organizing committee, and particularly to its chairman, Paul Sifrin, President Peter Juveroth, and to the more and also to the more than 50,000 volunteers who are giving so much for the success of these games. Finally, I have the high honor to invite the President of the United States of America, President Ronald Reagan, to proclaim the games of the 23rd Olympiad in Los Angeles open. God bless America.
Celebrating the 23rd Olympiad of the modern era, I declare open the Olympic Games of Los Angeles.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the entrance of the Olympic flag. The flag is escorted by a group of distinguished Americans. Bruce Jenner, gold medalist decathlon. Wyoming Tyus, gold and silver medalist track and field. Terry O'Brien, gold and silver medalist shot put. John Neighbor, gold and silver medalist swimming. Sammy Lee, gold medalist, platform and springboard diving. Patricia McCormick, gold medalist, platform and springboard diving. Richard Sandoval, member of the 1980 Olympic. Al Order, gold medalist, discus. Mac Robinson, silver medalist, track and field. Billy Mills, gold medalist, track and field. And Bill Thorpe, Jr., grandson of medalist Jim Thorpe. lit directly by the rays of the sun on the steps of the Temple Hetra. The Olympic torch brings flame from Greece. Los Angeles is proud to accept again this ancient and sacred symbol. Stadium by Gina Hemphill, granddaughter of Olympic gold medalist Jesse Owens. Will be lit by one of America's greatest athletes, Olympic gold medalist Rafer Johnson. Will the athletes please take their positions behind their placard bearer and please clear the podium? The flags of the nations pledged to honor Olympic ideals will now take their places for the ceremony of the Olympic oaths. Ladies and gentlemen, the parade of the national flag. Thank you. to take the oath on behalf of the athletes representing the United States Olympic team, Edwin Moses.
In the name of the athletes, I promise that we shall take part in the Olympic Games, respecting and abiding by the rules that govern them. In the spirit of true sportsmanship, for the glory of the sport and the honor of our teams.
To take the oath on behalf of all the judges and officials, Sharon Weber of the United States Olympic team.
In the name of all the judges and officials, I promise that we shall officiate in these Olympic Games with complete impartiality, respecting and abiding by the rules with which they govern them in the true spirit of sportsmanship.
Los Angeles has one of the most diverse ethnic origins of any city in the world. Entering now to honor the athletes are 2,000 citizens of this city in the dress of their native origin, representing the peoples of five continents. The athletes are gathered here to compete before the eyes of the world. The games, however, celebrate more than the spirit of competition. They celebrate the spirit of international brotherhood, the simple humanity that unites all of mankind.
Thank you.
Forever diverse, citizens of an earth grown small, an island in the endless sky, we still are bound in common destiny. Like ancient Olympia, let us celebrate man, and in peaceful contest, unlock his infinite possibilities. Here again, we find truce. Close the distance between all men, and join hands, each to each.
Reach out and touch somebody's hand. Make this world a better place if you can. Reach out and touch somebody's hand. Make this world a better place if you can. Join the celebration as we salute the unity. World a better place if we can. Reach out and touch somebody's hand. Make this world a better place if we can.
Reach out and touch,
reach out
somebody's hand.
Somebody. We all can claim that.
and gentlemen, the opening of the games of the 23rd Olympiad. Ladies and gentlemen, as the athletes of the 23rd Olympiad leave the stadium, let's all give them a rousing cheer and wish them a successful and rewarding Olympic experience. Good luck and Godspeed to them all.
Story. So let me Down and up, the only way is up, and I'll be up like a rolling.